Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's your bro here. Hope you're doing well. And in this video, I'm going to teach you guys how we can use the entry widget in Python to accept some user input. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. If you find this video helpful, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. Your support will help keep this channel running. All right, everybody, let's discuss the entry widget. What this is that it's a text box that accepts a single line of user input. A comparable example would be, let's say that you're logging into a website with your user information and password. Well, those text boxes that you enter your information into and hit submit could be an example of something similar to an entry widget for Python. So before we begin, make sure you have this import at the top. Then we'll create a window to add this entry widget to. So we'll create a window called window. Window equals TK, and then window.main loop to actually display this. Let's just test this. Yes, it's working. So in order to create the entry widget, we'll create a name for this instance of the entry widget. So let's just call this entry. Entry equals entry. And we don't necessarily need to pass in any arguments at this time. And then we're going to either pack this entry or place it on the window. So entry. And let's just use pack for now. So this should display our entry widget. However, you can barely see it and it kind of blends in with the background, but you can still type in something. All right, so let's mess with some of the configurations for this entry widget. So let's begin by changing the font size. So we can do that by typing in entry.config font equals, and then we can mess with the font style or the font size. So I think I'll pick ink free, but pick whatever font you want, and then a size. So font size 50. And let's try this again. That's a little bit better. Let's type in something. Bro code, blah, blah, blah. All right, not too bad. So let's change the background color now. Well, there's not really any good reason to, but you can. So let's try it. Entry.config bg for background color. And then you can always list a name like black, you know, blue, red, whatever you want. But let's pick a hexadecimal value. So you can always look those up. I will pick all ones. So that looks something like this. So let's type in something again, but you can barely see the text. So let's change the foreground color. So that is done with fg, entry.config, fg for foreground, and I will pick green. So the hexadecimal value for that is 00FF00. Otherwise, you can just put something like green here, and that works just fine too, but make sure you take out the number sign. And let's try it again. Bro, I think I'll make this a very bright green though, because that's kind of dull. So that's 00FF00. And let's try it again. What up, bro? All right, that's not too bad. Let's also insert some text. So this is some default text. So we can do that with entry.insert. We'll place a positional argument. We'll start with 0. And then we can enter in some default text, like SpongeBob. So then when we run this, the default text says whatever we type here. So now it says SpongeBob. But I think I'll remove that for now. You can also disable this text box as well. So we can do that with entry.config state equals disabled. So we can no longer type in anything within this entry text box. So I'll add a comment that this is either active or disabled. But I'll turn this into a comment because we still got a lot more to do with this. We can also set a width. So this width is in number of characters. So that is entry.config width. And let's set the max to maybe 10. So this doesn't cap or max out the number of characters that you can type in. It's just really for the size of the entry box. So it's only going to display a max of 10 characters at once, but let's test it out. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0. All right, so if we type in more numbers than that, more than 10, it's going to kind of scroll through the numbers. But yeah, I'll keep it at 10, that's fine. Ooh, I got a good one for you guys. So this next one is entry.config show. Show equals a certain character. So let's set this to asterisk. So this will hide all of the characters within the text box, and it's going to replace them with whatever character you have here. So this would work perfect for some sort of password. So if I were to type in something, it's only going to display whatever character that we have here. So this works perfect for a password. So we can actually change this too. It doesn't necessarily have to be an asterisk. Let's replace this with the dollar sign. So when we type in something, it's only going to display as whatever character we placed here. So that's how you can create a hidden password of some sort. Now, what good is an entry text box if we can't actually submit something? So let's create a submit button. So make sure you've seen the video on buttons for Python before you dive into this portion. So let's create a button. We'll call this submit. It's going to be a submit button. So submit equals button. We're adding this to our window, and let's set the text. Text equals submit. And then we're going to set the command for this to equal submit. So we're going to create a function called submit. So we'll do that right before we create this window, I think. So def submit. What do we want this button to do when we click it? So we'll create a variable, maybe username equals, and then to retrieve the text from a entry widget, we type in the name of the widget, entry.get. So this retrieves the text that we entered in and stores it within a variable called user. And then let's just print this. Print user name. All right, and then we need to add the button to the window. So we can just simply do that with pack. Submit.pack. And let's take a look. All right, so this button is on the top. We can actually change the position in which it's in. So within the parentheses of pack, what we can do is place this on a particular side. So let's say that we want this on the right side. So side equals right. And that's a little bit better. Let's type in a name like bro, hit submit, and it displays our name in the console window. Here's a crazy idea. When we print our username, let's concatenate this with another string. So maybe we can display hello before the username. So hello plus username. So type in whatever your name is, bro, submit, and it says hello bro. Pretty cool, right? Now let's create a delete button. So honestly, we'll just copy all this that we have for our submit button. And we'll change submit to delete. And we'll change the text here as well to delete. And the command to delete. So we'll make a delete function. So delete, 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 delete. Then let's create a delete function. So def delete. All right, so to delete the text in an entry widget, we can do entry.delete. We place two positional arguments within here. So we want to clear everything with this delete button. So the first positional argument is going to be 0. The second is going to be end. And what this does, and I'll just make this a comment, is that this deletes the line of text. And we'll set this to the right side, right next to the submit button. And let's test this. My name is bro something. And we're going to delete this, and everything is cleared out. And even if we hit submit, it doesn't really do anything. It just displays hello. Let's create a backspace button. So we'll copy this. We'll change delete to backspace. We're only going to delete one character at a time, and that character is going to be at the very end of our string of text. So backspace, backspace, text equals backspace, and command backspace. And we'll create a backspace function. So we'll do that at the top. Def backspace. All right, so this is gonna get a little bit tricky. Entry.delete. And we're going to place two positional arguments. The second is going to be end, because we want to delete the last character in our line of text. And the first character, the first positional argument, is going to be entry.get. Basically what we have here, except we're going to take the length of this, place this all within parentheses, and then subtract one. And this will delete last character. And now let's test this. So we have backspace, delete, and submit. Let's type in our name. So for me, that's bro code. Then when I hit backspace, it only deletes the last character. However, the delete button will still clear everything. And then for the last time, let's check submit. So bro code, then submit. Hello, bro code. Cool. So all of our buttons are now working. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that is the basics of the entry widget for Python. If you would like a copy of all this code, I'll post all of this in the comments down below. But yeah, that's the basics of the entry widget for Python. Hey you. Yeah, I'm talking to you. If you learn something new, then you can help me help you in three easy steps by smashing that like button, drop a comment down below, and subscribe if you'd like to become a fellow bro.